I'm Randy Robinson. This is Life Today TV. Today I have singer-songwriter Carrie Jobe with me. Carrie, glad to have you.
Thank you.
I felt like I've known you since we were both very, very young.
Yes.
So, but it's great to have you here as now the well-known singer you are.
Cool.
So very proud of your accomplishments.
Thank you.
How's it going? What's going on with you?
It's good. Just been pretty busy. Did a tour with Chris Tomlin and Louis Giglio. Finishing that and just pretty cool season. I'm just enjoying watching God do big things. And
what did you? I love Louis Giglio,
yeah.
By the way.
Yeah.
What great spiritual insight did you pick up? Because I know there had to be a lot of them.
Where would you even start? Just, I love his heart for just reminding us that it's just about Jesus. Mm. And if, you know, every night before you go out, just saying, just remember that it doesn't matter what anyone thinks of you or says of you. You're so accepted and loved by the Lord, and that's all that matters. So to go out with that knowing in your heart before you go and lead worship, it really, it changed my perspective. You know, you put a lot of pressure on yourself in ministry that it's about, you know, that you're, there's a lot of responsibility on you or something, and no.
Yeah.
It's to be a daughter and to be a son and to just love on the Lord, you know. And it was, it just was cool.
That's very
Louis.
Cool.
Yeah.
Now, you are a Christian singer, right? It has to just be, and you're doing well. I mean, your songs are getting tons of play. Everybody's singing them in church. Life must just be perfect for you.
Yeah.
Is it perfect?
No, it's not.
What do you struggle with?
You know, it's funny. It's like the Lord, we sing about, God, you're faithful. I trust you. I lay my life down. And it's like the Lord wants us to know that in our hearts. And that we're walking that out, not just saying those kinds of things. And I think it's important as leadership to go through things as well so that we can say, look, I'm walking through the fire just like you are. And the things that we're experiencing in life are not easy, but God is faithful. And here's why and here's how. And so it's been one of those seasons for me with family and just it's challenging. Healing, walking through healing in my own life of things that I deal with personally, you know, and having to cry out to the Lord. He is so faithful, and He meets us every time. Mm-hmm. And if I didn't know that, I think it would be harder to lead worship and be more, you know.
No doubt.
Realistic.
So. I was doing a book signing, and a woman came up and said, I feel like I'm to write this book, but I'm still struggling with it. And I don't know if I can even write about it because
it's
I don't feel like
timing.
I'm like, exactly. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, you know, you should.
It's perfect.
Do you ever write out of your own struggles?
All the time. Yeah. That's exactly where my songs come from. And I feel like this newer stuff, because I'm working on a new album, I feel like the newer stuff is way deeper than anything I've ever written because having to get on my face for real, like crying out to the Lord, searching the scriptures, God, what are you saying to me? And writing out of that perspective and out of that place is it's new, it's good, you know, and that's where everybody is. We're all going through those seasons of there's blessing in it. I mean, there's moments that you're excited and God's doing good things and other times where you're just like, God, where are you and what are you saying?
Yeah,
yeah, I am writing out of that.
Yeah. And those are the powerful ones, the songs, you know, that get you are the ones that get you because that's where you're at too.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it doesn't surprise me. God would let you go through things so that you can write those songs that people relate to.
For sure. I have a friend. We're writing a song right now, and they did it at church the other day to test it and see what it feels like congregationally. And there was kind of a prophetic moment that happened on it, and she was singing something about how storms are the things that God uses, the wind of the storm to be what pushes our sails and pushes us forward in our lives. And it's like, I think sometimes we think that the storms are stopping us from the future and stopping us from what the Lord is taking us into, but it's actually, it's just part of His process with us.
Mm-hmm.
And it's encouraging. Mm-hmm. You know?
Yeah, it is. Oddball questions. This is just the pop stuff, right?
Okay.
Who do you listen to musically?
Oh, I'm such a worship junkie, so I'm always listening to Bethel music and Jesus culture
and
Hillsong's new stuff. And I mean, to me, anything that like I can feel the presence of the Lord or the atmosphere shift, you know, it can shift one of two ways.
Yeah.
You feel darkness in music or you feel life in music. And I want to I listen to the life-giving stuff.
Yeah, very, very cool.
For sure.
Do you co-write or do you write?
Mm-hmm.
Do you do a lot of co-writing?
I do a lot of co-writing. I do write by myself, but a lot of times I'll take my songs and finish them with other people who can help
anyone
me.
Anyone in particular that you like working with?
Finish crafting. Oh, I love, there's so many different giftings, you know. One of my favorite people to write with is Matt Maher. He's
he's like,
you know, comes from a Catholic background, so his wealth of knowledge of the word is just so rich. Jason Ingram's another great writer, amazing to write with.
Speaking
Tom
of Matt
Lins,
Maher,
these guys,
okay, I went to the Glenn Beck thing at Cowboy Stadium.
Yes.
And you sang there.
Yeah, and
Matt
was
there. I knew you were singing there.
Yeah.
I did not know he was singing there.
Yeah.
He walked out, and I was like, oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
My wife's like, what? I'm like, that's Matt Maher. I was like, oh, this is the greatest thing ever. Because, you know, my dad invited me, you know, to the back. I was like, okay. I didn't know what to expect.
Yeah.
So, yeah, very cool. Very cool that he was there. Let me ask you this weird question, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Why Spanish?
Oh, yeah. I led worship in Colombia a couple years ago, and I just memorized songs because I don't speak Spanish yet. And I do a little bit, but not fluently. And so I memorized a lot of songs, and people would come up to me afterwards and speak and real fast
in
their beautiful language. And I was like, no, I don't speak Spanish. and I just fell in love with the culture. I just went to lead in Spanish, just went because they needed me to go on a mission trip. And I just fell in love with the passion, and that culture is so passionate. And so I just thought, I want to provide more tools of worship. I mean, I don't get to travel in South America very often. I will this summer.
So if you don't speak Spanish, how do you translate your songs?
I have people help me.
They come in and...
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I have to ask them, I'm like, so what does this say? Because you can't have complete literal translations,
right,
you know?
Right, because it doesn't fit.
Like my song, Sweep Me Away Where Nothing Else Matters, in Spanish it says, take me away, my love, where it's only you and me.
Nice.
I'm like, that's way more beautiful than the English.
Yeah.
So totally has to be rewritten.
All right, so what's on the horizon? What's the vision?
Live recording, about to do that, which is so my heartbeat. I'm a local church girl, grown up leading worship in church, so doing a live worship album is, that's just me, so I'm excited about it. And I'm just traveling, doing some touring. I'm doing the Women of Faith tour in the fall.
Yep.
So that's exciting, too.
Yep. Awesome. Yeah. Carrie will be on Life Today with the Women of Faith.
Yeah.
Be sure to check that out at lifetoday.org. Is it carriejobe.com?
That's right.
CarrieJobe.com. Check out her music. The new stuff coming out, getting better and better all the time. And
thank you.
Check it out. If you haven't heard her stuff, you're watching, so you probably know who she is. But if you haven't, go on YouTube and listen to some of it. Especially the acoustic stuff, by the way. Very nice on the acoustic stuff.
Thank you.
And great music. Thank you so much for spending a few minutes with us.
For sure.